Hello everyone, what's up? In this Photoshop video, I'm going to apply some lovely ghostly light on this foggy autumn day shot. And most of the post-processing will be done in the Adobe Camera Raw Editor, while I will be using Photoshop later to finish the editing. So without much more talking, let's jump into it. First off, what do I mean by ghostly light? Right now we do have a pretty gray, foggy day scene on this RAW file. For the ghostly light effect, I do want to have a way stronger blue color cast and also kind of desaturate everything else besides those blue tones. Also, I want to make the overall scene a lot darker. So let's start by changing the profile to Adobe Standard, just to lessen the contrast a little bit. Then I'm going through the basic stuff real quick. As I said, I want to have a blue color cast. That means I can right away go down with the temperature here. And I'm going to drop it quite a bit. All right. I'm not touching the tint. I think that looks fine for now. Then I also want to bring down the exposure. We are making this image a lot darker right away. Just like that. Of course, we don't want to lose too much in those highlights. So to counter that, I'm going to boost them. Just a little bit. And at the same time, we could also boost the whites a bit. So we get some nice contrast going on in this image. Awesome. Now let's see. Looking at the histogram, we can bring down the shadows a little more. Just like that. And I do want to have some faded blacks in here, so I'm going to boost the blacks. This will also help get a way softer look on this image. But as you can see, this will kind of lessen the contrast again. But it has a certain style to it, so I think it's okay in this case. And finally, let's just add some overall contrast. Perfect. Now, you can see after those base adjustments, we now have a way stronger blue color cast, which looks really, really cool on those foggy scenes. I do think I need to bring down the vibrance a bit. Just like that. And also, I do want to bring down the texture and the clarity to get an even softer look. Perfect. The top part looks fine for now, but I do think I need to adjust the foreground, and therefore I have a radial gradient applied right here because I just want to make this path leading through the forest a little brighter. So therefore, let's boost the exposure. Let's also boost the whites. Alright, and maybe the shadows. Okay, and we could play around with the temperature. I do want to add just a little bit. Perfect. And that's already it for the local adjustments. Now, let's work on the colors for a moment. I'm going to start in the color mixer tab with the hue. And here I do want to change the red and yellow hues. I want to make both tones look way more orange, so I'm going to boost the red hue and I'm going to drop the yellow hue. And that just makes the whole foreground look a lot more orange. In fact, we could also push the magentas since we have some subtle magenta tones in the foreground, and thus we will make them look a lot warmer. Then let's head into the saturation tab. Here I do want to boost the orange saturation a bit. Also, I want to bring down the aqua tones and the blue tones slightly. Maybe also the purple tones. But this will mostly affect the foreground again. Okay. Then let's check out the luminance tab. And again, I want to push the red luminance and the orange luminance and the yellow luminance. And all those three sliders will make the foreground a little brighter. And again, in this case, we can push the magenta tones as well, since there are a few in the foreground, so that looks pretty cool. Now let's check out the split toning. Here I do want to apply a cold color tone to the shadows, of course. Let's see. Something like this looks pretty cool. But let's bring down the saturation. Just like that. Awesome. We can do some more color grading in the calibration tab. Here, I just want to drop the blue primary hue. And let's also boost the saturation here. Okay, maybe we can boost the green saturation as well. But I think this looks pretty good. Compared to the before image, we do have a stronger blue color cast. And the overall scene looks a lot darker, so I am quite happy with this. Now let's open it up in Photoshop to finish the editing. First off, I do want to remove a few things, for example those little branches right here, because I think they are a bit distracting. And at this point I do want to check the Nick Collection plugin. And first off, let's apply the classical soft focus for a little more glow here. Of course, the first method might be a bit too bright. So I do think I want to go with the third one here. And let's see, maybe I'm reducing the strength. But this looks pretty cool. Let's see if we can add another filter, and I do have the Brilliance Warmth filter in mind. Here I do want to bring down the warmth, adding a lot more blue to the brighter areas up there. And I do think this looks much better. Let's actually maybe bring up the saturation. Alright, let's just apply it like that. And here we have the finished image. Although I did intend to have it a bit less saturated than in the beginning, I did end up with a way stronger blue color cast than intended. I think, however, this looks pretty cool. So I hope this video was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions left, feel free to ask me in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.